Hey everyone, welcome back. I'm Swati and you're watching Backyard Gardening. This is my terrace garden. As promised, I'm back with the terrace garden tour video. As you all know that my terrace is covered from top, so the entire place doesn't get direct sunlight. However, this part gets nice morning sunlight for about 4 to 5 hours. So I'll take you through what all is growing on my terrace. Let's start from here. Here I have two tubs in blue color. These are 40 liter tubs and I have grown brinjals. You can see there are so many brinjals which are ready to harvest. I have a separate video on brinjals, how to grow them from seeds, and you can grow them effortlessly. Believe me, it's very easy to grow if you are beginner in gardening, especially in vegetable gardening. You can start with growing brinjals. So let me show you. Here we have ready to harvest lots many brinjals, not just one or two, no less than 8 to 10 brinjals, and we have already harvested no less than 8 to 9 times. From past 2 months we have been harvesting brinjals almost every week, every other week. So here we have so many brinjals and they are all grown from seeds. Coming to the next pot, here in black color pot, this is a beautiful big plant which blooms in bright red color. Let me show you. Can you guess the name? This is Musenda plant. I have two varieties of Musenda, the red one, and I have one which blooms in peach color, and that is there in my front garden, and this one is in pot and it has grown so nicely. Coming to next pot, here I have Chiku or Sapota. It's a hybrid variety, dwarf variety plant, and it has already grown many Chikus or Sapotas. Let me show you. There are many fruits on it and this variety is really sweet. We have harvested couple of times and this is around 3 to 4 years old plant, and every year it produces lots many fruits. Coming to next pot, here I have strawberries in a rectangle shaped pot, and if you remember last year we propagated them. If you remember, if you haven't seen that video, I'll share the link, you can check it. And we grew these plants from the runners, from the mother plant, and they produced fruits also. Let's see how it performs this year. Coming to next pot, here again I have a 40 liter tub and we have radishes. I recently shared a video on how to grow radishes from seeds and I have shared the entire process, and we have harvested some as well in the same video, so do check it out in case you missed it. And there are few more ready to harvest, so soon I will harvest others as well. Here I have few peas plant. Let's see how it grows. And over there I have a hibiscus plant and it blooms almost every other day with 4 to 5 flowers, gorgeous orange color flowers. Coming to the next pot, here I have gingers. You can see this is a rectangle shaped pot. If you remember in May, I think in April or May, I shared a video in which I showed how to grow gingers from store bought gingers, right? So this is the update of that part, you can say. I will come up with a separate video when I'll be harvesting them and I'll share the entire process. Let me show you something over here. This is ginger flower. So this is a rectangle shaped pot, and over here in a round shallow pot, in fact shallow tub, here also I have grown gingers and they're also growing good. They'll be ready to harvest in about another 4 months, because when the leaves will all turn yellow and they'll start drying up, that will be the time when, you know, we'll harvest them. It takes time, around 10 to 11 months. Coming to next pot, here we have lemongrass and we put these leaves in tea. They have medicinal values as well. They are used to treat fever, cough, cold and all. However, they have nice fragrance and they are very good pest repellent as well. mosquito repellent. Here I have a huge ficus plant. This is Benjamin ficus plant, the green variety. This plant can be grown in full sunlight as well as in partial shade. Coming to the next pot, here I have four pots with chili plants, and there are so many chilies growing in them. Let me show you over here. There are few which are ripened, they are red, few are green, few are ready to harvest. We have already harvested 2-3 times, as and when we need, we harvest 5 to 10 chilies, and they are super spicy ones. And I have grown them from seeds itself, so I'll come up soon with a separate video with end-to-end process. I'll share the entire process with updates, and we'll harvest few chilies as well in that video, so stay tuned. So here in the next pot with chilies, I have few mint plants as well, and these mints I grew from the store bought mint only. I inserted few cuttings and they are growing really nicely. So here I have few tulsi plants in this pot along with cherry tomatoes, and few are already growing in there. If you remember, I think a couple of months back I shared a video in which I showed how to grow cherry tomatoes from store-bought cherry tomatoes, and we harvested a lot of them as well. Do check it out. It's super easy to grow. You can easily grow them in pots. And do you notice these gorgeous flowers? These are garlic vine. I have a separate video on this plant. The leaves, the flower, stem, everything smells exactly like garlic. And they bloom in bunch. And this plant has come all over to the terrace from my backyard. And you can see there are so many flowers there in the backyard. I have one creeper which has come all the way up. Here in the next pot, I have grown a cutting of hibiscus, the red variety. Here I have wandering dew. I kept few cuttings and it has, you know, started spreading in this pot as well. And this is sindoor plant, or a few people call it kumkum plant. I got it from my village last year. I got two plants. One I have in my front garden that has grown way bigger than this plant. Coming to the next pot, here I have basil. I use its leaves for pasta and all, and they smell divine. If you touch these leaves, crush them, and even you can eat them as a mouth freshener. They act as a mouth freshener. Coming to the next pot, these are chandni plants. Blooms in white flowers. Coming to the next plant, here I have a big plant of alamanda. They bloom in bell shaped yellow flowers. I have a creeper in my front garden. They bloom round the year, maybe because of pot it's not blooming profusely. Couple of weeks back it was blooming, and now it has started you know, turning its leaves yellow, maybe because of the fall season, not sure. So this is alamanda, and let's move further. Let's see what is there. So here in this rectangle shaped pot, can you guess which plant it is? This is turmeric plant, haldi. And I think around May or June I shared a video in which we grew turmeric, and from the store bought ones, raw turmeric. There in two pots I have arbi or colocasia. These are colocasia leaves, and they also are very easy to grow from store bought colocasia. I have a separate video on this. I will share the link, you can check it. They are grown for its leaves as well as for the root, and I will come up with a separate video when we will do the harvesting, and I'll you know, share the entire process of growing colocasia as well. Let me show you this side. What do we have? So over here I have shakarkand, which is sweet potato, growing in these three pots. This is a shallow pot. Last year also I grew and we harvested also. And if you haven't seen that video, link will be there in the description box. You can check them out. They are super easy to grow from store-bought sweet potatoes. And you'll get plenty of them if you grow in big tub or, you know, big pot or container. So here also, they are growing in a rectangle-shaped pot and two small tubs. So in another 3 months or 4 months, they'll be ready to harvest. Then again, I will come up with a separate video. In another 1 month, they'll start blooming. They bloom in beautiful purple color like a morning glory flower. So let me show you if you can see. Yeah, I can see there. They have started, you know, producing this, forming a sweet potato. I think you can make out. They're very small though in size, so it will take some time. So here we have sweet potato in 3 pots. Then comes pennywort plant in this pot. They grow aggressively and they're very easy to grow. You can grow them in water as well as in normal soil, but they like to sit in, you know, soggy soil. Coming to the next pot, here I have Epiphyllum oxypetalum, that is night queen. If you remember, I shared a video how to grow them from cutting, and we grew them from the leaves itself, and it has, you know, produced this huge stalk with leaves, and it produced flowers also twice since I have grown them from cutting. So they're super easy to grow. Do check out the video. Here I have this chutney plant, blooms in white color, same as there I have showed you, right? And Furio plant and Dumkin, few plants in this single pot. Over here we have 2 pots of Colocasia. Then comes the next big pot in which I have Tulsi. I have Tulsi plant in many pots here and there. They keep growing along with vegetables as well. So here is the gorgeous plant, which is a Starlight. It's a variety of ficus, variegated leaves. And as and when winter comes, they start shedding their leaves, and by the time spring will come, February onwards, they will start producing leaves and lots many new branches, and the plant will get full. Then here I have few aquatic plants in tubs, and they are all covered with this plant. This is Pistia, water cabbage, water lettuce. I have separate video on this. They are very easy to grow and they grow aggressively. Like once you grow them, you can't get rid of this plant. They'll take over the entire pot. So in 2 pots I have this plant. Then coming to this tub, this is hyacinth plant, or Jalkumbhi we call it. They bloom in gorgeous lavender color flowers that looks like orchids. I have a separate video on this. Do check it out. Coming to this pot, this is Singhara or water chestnut. We grew it from the store-bought water chestnut, and recently I shared a video in which we harvested as well. So I'll share the link. You can check the entire process. Its season is there, so you'll easily get water chestnut in the market. Buy some and grow your own plant. Coming to the last plant over here on the terrace, this is Bird of Paradise plant. They bloom in gorgeous red and yellow flowers. I have many of them in my front garden, so I thought of, you know, just growing them in one pot. I had put one plant only, and you can see how many of them have, you know, come up in this now. Its leaves looks very beautiful. They are super easy to grow from root division method. I'll come up with a separate video soon on this plant. So these are few plants that I have on my terrace, and as you guys can see, the terrace is covered from top, so I cannot keep many plants on terrace which needs full sunlight. So as I told you earlier, like this part gets nice morning sunlight for about 4 to 5 hours. So that's the reason I have kept more of my vegetable plants or tubs this side. And I think that's all for today. And if you like the video, do let me know through comments, and I will come up soon with one more interesting video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye bye.